yo-yo Ma, alongside his good friend, pianist Catherine Stott. They played the final movement from the Cello Sonata No. 1 by French composer Gabriel Fauré. From APM American Public Media, this is Performance Today, a daily guided tour of today's classical scene. I'm Valerie Kaler, sitting in for Fred Child. Still to come this hour, a remarkable story of musical lost and found. We'll hear some of the happily rediscovered music by American composer Florence Price. And right now, the sound of a young woman named Melisande working at her spinning wheel. Melisande is a character in a play from 1892. The play is called Pelias and Melisande. She is deeply in love, but not with the man she's married to. She's in love with his brother.
Uh-oh.
It's a love triangle that can't end well, and doesn't end well. What's remarkable about the play, Pelias and Melisande, is not so much the story, rather it's the way the story is told. Nothing is spelled out. It's all suggestion, implication, almost a kind of drawing with smoke. Just as an image begins to take shape, it's already beginning to dissipate. The shadowy world of Pelias and Melisande turned out to be irresistible for composers. In a few years after the play appeared, four major composers wrote music inspired by the play. Let's hear what Gabriel Fauré wrote for a London production in 1898, a suite from Pelias and Melisande by Gabriel Fauré. Thank you. go along with a dark, melancholy play. Gabriel Fauré wrote that music in 1898 for a London production of the play Pallias and Melisande. He strung together his favorite parts of the music for that suite, which we heard from a concert in Germantown, Tennessee. Conductor Michael Stern led the Iris Orchestra. The suite from Pallias and Melisande by Gabriel Fauré. The ensemble we just heard, the Iris Orchestra, a lively, inventive, part-time group based just outside Memphis, Tennessee. Many of the players hold down full-time jobs with top orchestras. The Boston Symphony, the Cleveland Orchestra, Philadelphia Orchestra, the San Francisco Symphony, and more. They get together several times a year in Germantown. Conductor Michael Stern founded the group back in 2000 and is still principal conductor of the Iris Orchestra. In a moment, new music inspired by Bach.
Really?
Listening to performance today from APM.
My experience with Price and William Grant Still is the audience absolutely loves the music.
John Jenner and the Fort Smith Symphony have just released a new recording celebrating the symphonic music of Florence Beatrice Price. Go to our website to sign up to win your own copy of this new recording and listen for it this week on New Classical Tracks from Classical Minnesota Public Radio, sharing the power of classical music. Programming on Classical Minnesota Public Radio is supported by Copper Street Brass, celebrating favorites of American music from Aaron Copland and Willie Nelson, Brass, and more at their Route 66 concert. That's happening Saturday, March 2nd at Sundin Hall in St. Paul. You can get a whole lot more.